If rice and beans is a staple in your Christmas dinner, well, you might want to start stocking up on the beans. These precious legumes have become like gold. They are in short supply at the Michael Finnegan Market, along with other vegetables used in everyday cooking.
Vegetables is really scarce right now. Cilantro, cabbage. We don't got cabbage in the market right now. No beans in the market. All beans scarce. All beans. It's like, when we get, it's 250 for one sack.
And for some of the vegetables that are available, the prices are exorbitant, almost double in some cases.
Cilantro has gone up. We're paying $60 for one bag. We got 5 pounds, and it come up like for $12 a pound, so we have to sell it like for 15. The cabbage, we are paying like $200 for one sack of cabbage, local, and it's not really that pretty cabbage. And when we clean it, we get like 20 pounds out of waste. So it's not a big profit we make on cabbage right now.
You have cabbage, you have sweet pepper, you have cilantro. But all of these vegetables are due to the weather, right? According to the farmers. So normally we would pay like $3 for a pound of sweet pepper, now it's up to $6. Cabbage, like $1.50 a pound, $3.50 a pound right now. But that, we buy like a sack of cabbage at nearly $2.50 a sack for 100 pounds, right? So we can't sell it for it. Then we have to buy a bag.
The marketing right now, that is cilantro, the carrots, $2.50 a pound for carrots. $4 a pound for cabbage, $6 a pound for sweet pepper.
What were the prices like a few months ago?
Well, to be straight, Miss Sweet Pepper, I'm going to go for $1 a pound. Carrots. Well, to be straight, then we got $1 bag of carrots. So come again, $1 bag of carrots. You know, we're going to go and say, one pound of carrots, $1.50 the most. When we got a pound of carrots, we're going to go for one pound of cabbage. We get $1 cabbage, again, a pound of cabbage, $1.25. But not right now.
And now, the vendors are left between a rock and a hard place. If they don't raise prices, they risk making losses because flooding has made supplies scarce. The floods that affected mostly the Cayo and Belize districts have washed away fruits and vegetables that tend to grow closer to the ground. One Mennonite farmer says he has no choice but to hike up his prices.
He says as he have watermelon plant, cantaloupe, sweet pepper and cilantro, but they got the flooding. Make it, everything spile. ¿Cómo se dice?
Que subirla para que yo consiga mis gastos.
Well, he say he has to raise it to get the expense that he has already invested in what he's already lost.
And from the farm to the table, consumers are also feeling this pinch. One food vendor told us that she doesn't want to raise her prices, but she may soon have no other option.
I got a little business and like, when I come by the thing there, the price there, oh my goodness, we start with the cabbage, $3 a pound. I don't know why they got it so high. Then the red beans, you got some of them, you get it for $2.75, $2, and the beans then hard. They affect me a lot because then like, I ain't even worried the price of my stuff. Ne. I don't know what to do sometimes, so maybe like, I don't have to cut them smaller, for try to make one little profit. Because then, like, sometimes when I do sell the thing, for instance, right now the cabbage I buy, I have to tell my daughter when I have to cut down on the sauce, all right? Because usually when people come, they want a lot of the sauce, the pepper sauce especially.
Courtney Menzies, 7 News.